Hey there, welcome back to part 2 of our labels tutorial. So today we'll be talking about the rest of our label settings, starting with the icon. So the icons are, for example, this green play button over here or the drone photo over here. So it's basically going to replace this white panel dot. And you can, again, add anything you want. I would recommend the PNG, so it's transparent. I'm just gonna load the Metareal logo like that, and yep, so now our dot is the logo. It's a little small though, so I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger by changing the icon size. Let's say 0.8. yep, okay, that's maybe too big, so 0.6. yeah, that's, I think that's perfect. And if you want to keep your labels uniform and have all the same icons and the same icon size, you can just hit apply to all icons over here. But our labels are not uniform, so I'll just leave this alone. So next section is the URL link. So if we switch quickly to our drone label over here and click on it, so you can see that this one has a URL inside of it, and that basically allows the user to teleport to this position when they click on it. It doesn't have to be a teleport URL. You can add any URL you want. Like, I can add this Girlfriend Ipanema video again if I want, or maybe a URL to the Eco Center. And you can change whether it shows up on the same tab where your tour is or if it opens in a new tab. And last one, user action. So user action is basically SDK stuff. Requires some JavaScript knowledge. So if we open our developer's documentation over here. So let me just show you some examples of what you can do using the SDK and labels. So I'll click examples over here. And let's pick interactive virtual tour. I'll also change the size a bit so you can see better. So I click play. Okay, so we have a bunch of labels over here. And if I click this one, it's gonna open a pop-up of sorts in our tour. So this pop-up is not part of our tour, is part of the web page. So if I click full screen, it's actually gonna disappear. So the SDK will basically let you use labels as triggers for website events. So you can imagine, maybe I am in front of this shelf and I have this label over here, and if I click on this label, it will change the background of this page to show off a particular product that I want to sell. Or maybe it would suddenly show some historical notes about this particular artifact on the left pane. So if you want to explore this further, you can click view code over here to see how this was written and browse the rest of the documentation. So let's get back to our main topic over here, which is creating labels. Okay, so URL links. The user action that will let you use the SDK is only available to URL labels. Desktop or mobile label and VR label can only use URL link to open links in the same tab or new tab. Okay, so that's the content section done. Now let's move on to the box size. So the box is this container where we put the contents of our label. It automatically resizes to fit your label contents, but if you're not happy with that, then you can definitely make it bigger. So for example, it's at 300 pixels right now. I can make it 500 if I want, and that will extend my width. I can also base it in terms of percentage, and this is percentage of the page. So if I put 33%, then this would be 1/3 the width of the whole page. And if I put 100% over here, then this would take up the entire height of the page. And again, apply all if you want to apply this box size to other labels. Now moving on to styling. So this first part, it allows you to change the border of our box. So for example, we can make this red, and we can make it, let's say 3 pixels thick, and add some padding. So padding is the space between your content and your box. And we can make this, say 25. Yep, so there's a lot more space. Background color is this white thing over here, so we can make this maybe a little closer to the what's on the ground. Okay, that is too dark. Maybe somewhere here. Okay. And then hover color is the color that shows up if you hover your mouse over this box. And we can change that to, let's say, white. Yep, so now when I hover over it, it turns white. And background opacity, one means that it is fully opaque. If it's 0.5, then it is half transparent. We can sort of see through into the background. It's not really possible to have completely transparent background by setting this to 0. So if you want it to be as transparent as possible, just make this 0.001. And it should barely be there. But I think I like 50, the look of 50. So I'll switch back to that. Oh, sorry. Remember to add a point over here. So it goes from 0 up to 1. So decimals. And for link style, right now it's none. But if we switch to arrow, then this arrow thing is going to appear. And if we change it to line, it's going to change into a dot with a line. Divot is like what you would expect from a speech box. And all of these options will be layered on top of your icon. So in this case, I would switch to none. So it's a bit cleaner. And moving on, we have display position. So we have two display positions. We have floating and then we have fixed in screen space. So the main difference between these two is floating, when I look around, my label stays in the same position relative to the label anchor or the icon. But if I select fixed in screen space, then when I look around, it will stay in the same position relative to my screen. So right now it's in the center of the screen. I can switch it to the left or the right and so on. Let's explore floating first. So the first option is angle relative to anchor. So you can think of our anchor as the middle of a clock. If I change this to 0 degrees, it's going to be at 3 o'clock. And if I change this to 90, it's going to be at 6 o'clock. So it starts from here and then moves clockwise over here from 0 to 360 degrees. I think I liked it at 0, so we'll keep it there. Then length from center to anchor changes the distance. Let's make it 300. Okay, so now our label is much further away from our anchor than it was. Now let's explore fixed in screen space. So again, you can switch from left, center, or right. And you can change the margin, which is how far away is our box compared to the edge of the screen. So we can make this, for example, 100, and there will be a much bigger margin over here. So switching back to floating, let's explore the last bit of our label drawing tool. So we have visibility. First, for the label box, always open means wherever I am in the tour. So let's jump to this panel. Yep, this will still be visible. As long as I can see this anchor over here, as long as I have visibility to that, I'm going to be able to see my label. But if I go to a panel that has that label blocked, then I won't see it. So moving back to this spot. Okay. So that can be good or that can be annoying depending on what you want. Usually the option you would like is something like open on click, which means let's say we move over here and we look to this side. We will have to click on this label for the contents to show up. So those are the two extremes. In between, you have open on the same panel. So as long as you're in the same panel, you'll be able to see this label. And open in the same room. Again, if you want labels to open automatically as you transition through rooms, this is the best option. And these two are only available for floating. If we shift to fix in screen space, these are the only options that you have. Okay. And lastly, visibility of icon. Always visible is the first option as long as you have line of sight to that particular spot. So in this case, we don't have line of sight, so the icon will be closed. You also have the option to only show the icon if you are on the same panel. So if we select this and we move to a different panel that still has visibility to this spot, line of sight to this spot, you see that our icon has disappeared. And even if we click on it, it's not going to load our label. So we have to be in the same panorama. And that's the only way we can access this label. Or we can select it to only show in the same room. Yep, so that's pretty much it for labels. As you can see, it's a very flexible tool. And your imagination is the limit. If you haven't checked this feature out yet, I would recommend exploring it, giving it a try. This can really take your tours to the next level. And if you have any more questions, please feel free to leave a comment under this video and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. And that's it for today's tutorial. Happy tour building!